Hey guys, give me an update on the MX618 tires. I just managed to cut all four of them, made them look like a Mamba, removed 9 pounds per tire. So I'm going to show you some tire weights. Put a little chart together, all the tires I've weighed recently all on the same scale. I'll show you that right now, and then I'll show you my method for cutting all these tires and giving myself carpal tunnel. And also this little crazy hot wire thing I made. Didn't really work, but it's interesting. So here's a little Excel table I made of all the tires I've done recently. As you can see, before I cut the MX618, they were 54.8 pounds. After cutting them, they're 46 pounds. So now they're actually lighter than an Outlaw 331 and lighter than my Silverbacks. They're still a lot heavier than a 32 Aztec, which is far superior. But I did make them a lot more reasonable. You got to remember, though, they're on a 17-inch wheel, so that's going to add 3 or 4 pounds. Over to the right are some wheels I weighed recently. It's a good chart for you guys. All these charts are posted on the Mud Puppy Q&A Facebook page.
About halfway done with the first tire, so I've got it kind of down, so I'll show you my technique. It's different for every tire because every tire is different shape knobbies, but if you run the file over it every couple knobbies, that seems to help. And then the first thing you do is you make a cut straight down where you want to stop. That's the dangerous one, obviously, where you could, you know, potentially go too deep and destroy your tire. So be careful with that. Then you turn the tire this way and you cut off the top portion of the meat. So that first cut doesn't need to be too precise because you're just taking off the top chunk to get it out of the way to make it easier to do the detailed work. So then you come down here and you take off this angle corner piece kind of. This is far from ideal. It's very time consuming. I'm wanting to make a better method, but I'm not quite there yet. So now this is when you start going for detail, try to get it pretty close to the carcass. And then sometimes it's necessary to go and actually cut down a little bit more, but that one ended up okay. So this doesn't get it perfect. This gets most of the rubber off, and then you can go and clean this up with a, what do you call it, a sand paddle wheel. But you can get it pretty close with just this tool. If you don't care too much about looks, that's all you really gotta do. I spent the afternoon playing with tires for the most part. So here are the Black Bear 618s on the Talon, missing all this, every other knobby. So they look like a Mamba basically. They're a lot lighter than Mambas, and they flex a little better. Mambas are actually harder. After I got real aggressive with the Sawzall and started cutting down into the carcass, they actually are going to flex a little bit with all that rubber removed. That's about half the rubber I removed. End up removing 9 pounds per tire. This whole trash can is also full of rubber. One tire is 9.5 pounds, one's like 8¾, but about an average of 9 pounds per tire. And they really open the tread up, so you know it'll clean out better and actually flex a little bit. Looks pretty freaking mean. If I was gonna do it again, I'd probably just take the Sawzall and just lop off from here every other knobby. Then you don't run the risk of having to cut straight down to the carcass and damage the tire. I did go down to the nylon in a few spots if I can find one. I was getting a little over aggressive, yeah. So into the nylon there, that tire might fail. It's an $80 tire, whatever. So I did this one first, this passenger front, and I did the entire tire with the Harbor Freight oscillating tool. This one blade did all four tires, by the way. This worked okay. It's just slow, and I don't have the patience for that. This took me about 2 hours through that one tire. It used to be a little more square. I found that rounding the edges helped it cut faster. But that was too slow, and I got, you know, after that, I'm like, okay, I'm not spending 2 hours per tire. So then I made this thing. This is a, I thought it was gonna be the future of tire cutting. Unfortunately it's not. So this is just a little power supply and a fuse and two pieces of steel and canthal. If you're familiar with canthal, I think it's called canthal. Yeah, it's similar, so you can see, I don't know if you can tell, it's glowing. So I was trying to use this to cut tires like a hot knife. And the problem is, it kind of wants to set the tire on fire, even at 3 volts. If we go up to, let's go up to 6 volts. It's glowing, and it broke. So, let's set the tire on fire. And it broke. So it gets weak, more current. And then it pops. So it's basically a fuse, but it's pretty strong at low power, but it still didn't cut through the tire fast enough for me. So I made that thing for pretty much no reason. Little Amazon power supply, piece of wood. And this is a 24 gauge, like 0.5 millimeter. Anyway, so I tried that, that didn't work. So then I got out the old Sawzall. This is the fastest way to cut tires. It's just kind of dangerous. I took a regular blade and I filed down the edges of it to make it kind of like a knife, but still have some serratedness to it. And that cuts through the tires like butter. It's like not even fair. I took the guard off so I could get in there deeper. But I mean, it just cuts the knobbies off and it does a really pretty job. It actually cuts smoother than the oscillating tool. Of course, it's a Sawzall, so you might undercut this knobby too far. You might cut down into the carcass. You might cut too deep. So if I was gonna do it again, I'd just take the Sawzall and I would just, if you look at this knobby, I would just lop off like that. Boom, boom, boom. I could do 10 minutes of tire and get 80% of the weight off and not risk damaging the tire. And it would look like crap, but I don't care. This doesn't look great anyways. The only reason I went ahead and finished them all was because I already had done one. So I had to get them all the same weight, roughly. So this is a 99% Sawzall. The only thing I used the oscillating tool for on these other three was to cut straight down, to do that cut and not go too deep because it's easier to control the oscillating tool. Look pretty mean though. Tread spacing is about the same as an Aztec now. Significantly heavier, obviously, but we'll give it a shot. It doesn't really sit that high. The suspension's kind of perched up from me changing the tires. But yep, pretty freaking hilarious. Smells like rubber in here big time. Also, the talon's back together. I don't know if I made a video on YouTube yet. It's made a full recovery. New plastic, new fender, new brackets underneath. This is actually the original fender flare. So it came out pretty good. It's a little beat up looking now, a little broken in, but it handled the flip well. Nothing major was bent, just these little headlight brackets and stuff. I had to put a new headlight, new radiator. Radiator was kind of jacked up. I may have put this in another video, I don't remember if I put it on the Facebook page or not, or just YouTube, but that's the radiator. Anyways, talon's good to go, and it's on some new rubber. As soon as this Corona thing is over with, we'll go take it out.